recording in progress. Because you're already stressing me out, I'm going to light some incense.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to WLOL 98.8. Who's laughing out loud? It's you. My name is Elijah, and I'm here with my gay brother, Hubble.
Hey, I'm gay brother.
We're listening to Exod Rise Up, and I'm going to fade that out.
I actually wrote this.
Hubble wrote that. So
the first thing I want to get into is I actually have a segment, and it's called What's New, Girdle Girl? All right, so I got an interesting email from Miss Girdle, and I'm going to be showing you it.
Does Miss Girdle know you like that?
I found her email on the WLOL website because you were kind of withholding information from me. So I don't know if her name is, I think it's pronounced Denise.
Oh, like Denise, yeah.
Yeah, but it's Denise. So, hi, Hubble. Nice to hear from you. I thought you were off the grid, smiley face. I listened to the latest show and thought it slayed. You guys really went all out with the catchphrases. Check out the t-shirt I designed. What do you think? Should I get a few for the station? I thought that looks pretty cool. So, I'm looking forward to the next episode. Keep up the great work, y'all. Smiley face. And then I guess she's been kind of sick. She's been sick lately. I don't know.
Oh my god, you did not.
What? What's wrong?
Your email below, I can see, honey. You've been looking for a new co-host for WLOL.
I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, okay.
I can see your screen.
Oh.
You shared
it. I just shared this upper part.
Did you get me? What did she say?
She didn't say anything about it. I was kind of mad. See, I feel like you missed my question.
The vibe I'm bringing? What vibe do you think?
So it's a bad vibe.
What would you have? What would you want? Maybe I can try
someone
to
less icky. Maybe someone who doesn't bring bad vibes. Someone who brings good vibes and isn't icky.
Give me examples. That's what my therapist always says. Give me examples, honey.
Give me examples. Okay, so. Sometimes it just feels like you're out to kill me and you just want to kill me.
Okay, so won't kill you. I could do that.
Okay.
Next.
Two, not icky.
First of all, can do that. Two, not icky. What does that mean? I can't take a shower every day. That's not in my nature.
Yeah, I think maybe it's more about the vibes too. So it's kind of icky vibes, bad vibes. I don't know. I'm just shopping around, and she didn't reply about it. So hopefully by the next episode, maybe I'll find someone else who can take over.
Okay, so this is bringing me into a lot of other segments I had lined up because I did have one about gifts, which obviously is kind of represented here. Oh, I was also thinking we could commemorate each show to somebody, kind of memorialize somebody. But honey, I think this show is my memorial.
It might be. Or... And maybe you stick around. We could commemorate this to Miss Danish Girdle or Denise.
Is it unprofessional to take a phone call? My friend called me 3 times.
You can go ahead and take a phone call.
Okay, I'll mute.
I won't mute.
Say a little bit.
The stuff that I was telling Miss Girdle about. You take a lot of phone calls and you cut them out.
Is my audio shared?
No, you need to reshare it, honey.
Oh, okay.
You need to be on the ball.
There's a long lead up. Sorry, I'm about to rap about what just happened.
Looks like you lost another one.
Hubble's trying to cut me out the show. I told him, fuck you, no, 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 no. He talking to Miss Girdle behind my back. I tell him, honey, that's kinda whack. If you wanna talk to me, you better let me know. Or else, honey, you're gonna be the one who's about to go. I could get a co-host in like 5 seconds, cause everybody knows that you're the real antagonist. You have anything to say? I'm all ears.
Bad vibes, bad vibes. Your vibe attracts your tribe. Bad vibes, bad vibes. I'm just trying to vibe, you know? You ruined everything for me.
I'm just leaving it there.
You shared your whole screen. We know you are mean. Talking to Miss Girdle, you know her first name. You put it on the internet, honey, you're the one to blame. You got your black nail polish, we know you are gay. Hey, Freckle Cam,
keep those freckles.
I had to take a phone call, and he's all... Oh, ears. You always take phone calls.
Unprofessional.
Who the fuck else could deal with your bullshit? Ooh. You wanna get a no cost? Well, fine. But let's see how much Sylvie lasts this time. Oh! She didn't like you for one episode, honey. She probably doesn't even watch this show. She hates your guts. We're all out to get you. We've been sending emails. I email Sylvie every day like, hey, you heard Hub? She's like, oh, I hate that dude. Uh-huh. I feel like I'm going too hard on you.
No, it's good.
You can...
I like it.
I'm ready for your response.
Honey, I just needed some fresh vibes in this show. I just needed for someone to maybe go. I can only do like 2 lyrics.
Go where? Where you going? You be showing somebody love. That's not enough. Cause I am your guy. But you want me to die.
I don't know if that's true or not, but I know that you always... Oh, how much longer is the beat? Because I'd like it to stop so I don't have so I have a good excuse.
Honey, I'll just switch to the next one.
Oh.
No, I'm just kidding. Let me see. I feel like it's wrapping up right now. Go, go, go.
I just want you to know that I never wanted this to affect us, and I was really just looking out for the show. I hope you know. Right, well, so that was What's New, Girdle Girl?
I don't know if we should be putting her email out there online.
She's 42 years old.
You said it was on the website, right?
It's on the website. WLOL.
Okay. I guess it's time for me to do a segment. Awkward sauce. Okay, here's my next segment. What the hell is my next segment? Well, I don't even know what the hell to do. You're shaking me up to my core. But let's do... 30 hertz straight. This is kind of loud. Let's do this segment called Sound the Alarm. In this segment, we're going to have a couple combos, and we're going to take turns. But during each turn, one person can only communicate using sounds. Hey, Heavy, what's up? How was your day? Who the fuck are you texting on the show? Oh no, is there a celebrity? This is how your day was? What you got next?
All right, here we go.
Wait. Actually, do you think that segment was a bust or nah? Remember or nah?
I would say 67% bust. All right.
Okay.
All right, it's time for Cringe Corner. You need to be naming something cringe that you did today. All right, I'll go first. Today I was dipping Nabisco Oreos into a cup of water, which is cringe in itself. I was dipping them into water, and then the cookie fell apart into the water, and so I put my whole fist into the cup and fetched out the Oreo.
Okay.
On the magic school bus, everyone, follow me into the light. I will see you in the night. Trust me. Ooh, on the magic bus, I have a pimple filled with pus.
Okay.
I thought that was your music. I thought that was your rap music.
Here's cringe. When I was living near a lake, I would get shit out of the lake. And I had this little, well, I thought it was glue. I was using it like glue for a while. I just found it in the lake, brought it out. The label was all fucked up, so I couldn't tell what it was. And I later realized it never dried, and it was just some type of like lubricant oil.
Wow. Maybe it was cooking oil.
Did
it stink? How would the smell is?
Smell? No smell at all. And it was clear.
How would the smell is?
Yeah, so I could oil up my gears, but I don't have any gears yet to oil.
Are you going
to
get a bike?
I am going to get a bike. I'm going to go. Okay. Okay.
New rule.
New segment.
Hey, everybody.
I'm getting a bike.
Be careful, because this is a situation that could happen. Listen.
Okay. Wouldn't the scream come before the siren? Or what was the siren about?
They're on different layers, so I can't.
Okay.
So that's something you might need to be watching out for.
That was awesome. Yes!
Agreed.
I'm so fucking proud of you!
Riding a bike is like riding a bike, but the gear, the pedals are on fire, the seat's on fire, and the road's on fire.
And you're on fire today, Hubbo.
Woohoo!
You are on fucking fire for Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm loving it. Hey, is this kind of how you imagine the new co-host to be? We got a fight.
Yes. Come on, let's play. I think you kind of ruined Cringe Corner. That sucks.
I know.
You kind of turned it into Bike Bash.
This segment is called Pros and Cons. We're going to talk about the pros and cons of certain types of guys. I'm going to do a little rap here, but maybe at the end of this segment we can do another little rap. Hubble's on his phone. I don't like the tech guys. They always look like they're in a little disguise with his pink glasses on. I don't even see his on. Got a
eyes.
Finger.
You had ample opportunity to rhyme guys with eyes. Just saying.
Okay, let me start over. I don't like the tech guys. Look like they're in disguise. Pink glasses cover the eyes. Not so wise. Dumbass. Oh. Freckle alert.
Check.
Okay, so our first one, we're going to list all the pros and cons of shy guys. What do you think, Hubble?
Shy guys. Like from Mario?
No, but if you want, sure.
It's kind of a nerd joke.
Tech guy alert.
So shy guys. Pros and cons. Bro, you could probably make them blush really easy, which would be really cute.
Oh, I love that. Okay, I love that about Shy Guys. Oh. I love that about Shy Guys. But another pro about Shy Guys is they're not talking all the fucking time.
I'll give you that one. I'll hear you on that one. Man, I don't like when people don't shut the fuck up. You know what I mean?
Some people, they don't shut the fuck up.
Some people, they talk way too much, way too fucking loud at all hours of the day. And that shit pees me off. And the piece is short for pisses.
Pisses girdle. I don't mean to interrupt you. What's next?
Ignoring whatever you were saying. All right. Next thing. Next pro of a shy guy.
Why are you jumping in so fast to just do big sighs? Okay. All right.
I didn't get another pro in.
Okay.
Another pro would be... if they're packing heat meat, you wouldn't have heard about it already. It would be a surprise. So that's a pro.
Okay.
That's really important to me. That's what...
It's important that you're not hearing about it. Is that what's important?
I was saying that the heat meat was important to me, but no, I don't even like that. I don't even like looking at that area.
Those are some of the pros of Shy Guys. Shy Guys, we love you.
Shouts out to Shy Guys.
Shout out to Shy Guys. Okay, another pro of a shy guy is even if you get rejected by a shy guy, he's usually going to be kind of nice about it, and it kind of will be a funny story to tell afterward.
I usually don't have to worry about rejection.
I don't know. I was gonna have a segment called Reflection on Rejection, but I was gonna go, that's kind of not a very funny. I was gonna just tell stories about when I got rejected. But so basically what I'm trying to say is if I'm getting rejected, I know this one's getting rejected. I'm just kidding.
No, that's totally true. All right. I think I'm ready to move on to the cons.
Yes, get into the cons.
All right. So my number one con would be you wouldn't know what the fuck they're feeling because they probably wouldn't be able to tell you because they probably have no emotional intelligence.
Yes. Yes. I was going to say something similar because, it's so hard to tell. Are you being shy and liking me, or are you just... being shy and not liking me?
Sounds very different from what I was talking about.
No, that's not what. Okay, how is that not the same?
Okay, I guess the common denominator there is that in both situations you don't know what the person is thinking because they're shy.
What was the difference?
I was just being nitpicky. There's probably really no. No difference.
Yeah, I did not hear a difference at all.
Look, I'll be the first to admit I was wrong.
Yes, you were. See, I'm on the sound effects today. Okay. I love your con. I love your con. Another con about shy guys. You only can dance with them at a party if they get a little tipsy.
I'll give you that. Make the ding sound. You just said a second ago you were on top of it, and then you're showing me maybe you're not so on top of it. Like, here's another con. What if the shy guy was a con man? You wouldn't know because he's shy, and that's kind of a con. Because he wouldn't make it clear, like, I'm stealing money from you.
Yeah, you don't know what's going on with these guys, but they are adorable.
Shy guys, we love you. Hey, we love you.
Shy guys, we are in love with you.
Hey, I can't hear you. Oh. Can you say hello?
Hello? Hello?
Not working.
Do
Your bars are all red.
Could you hear my celebration music?
No, can you play it again? Didn't hear anything.
This is your celebration.
Is this a royalty-free song?
What'd you say?
Is that a royalty-free song?
No. Okay, our next guys to talk about the pros and cons are Russian guys.
Ooh,
Russian guys,
I got a lot to say about this. Got a lot to say about some Russian guys.
We got a lot to say about Russian guys.
All right, well, here's a little anecdote because I'm sick of this pro-con shit. So tomorrow, I'm having my friend Misha take me to the surgeon for my mouth because there are still problems with my mouth. And they said on the phone that they were going to explain things to Misha, and I know that's going to be a mess. It's not going to go well.
But he's super smart.
Smart. It's just going to make him really nervous because he's going to try to remember it all, and he's going to be all fucked up. And the other thing is, I'm planning on not having him take me to my apartment because I know it's going to stress him out to get me up 3 stairs and unlock the door. So I'm just having him take me to his place.
Oh, that's sweet. How long are you going to be there?
I'm going to be there for 3 days straight. Mm. And he's going to have to wash me.
Honey, that's the pro of a Russian guy.
That's the pro of a Russian guy. He will die for you. He will fucking die for you.
He really will. He will die for you. Yes. That's the pro of a Russian guy.
Khan, he will die for you. That's kind of a... Have you ever heard of a double-edged sword? Honey.
Bittersweet moment.
Ooh. Say, what's like another, crunchy like smooth peanut, soft like crunchy peanut butter?
I don't even know what you're getting at right now.
I was trying to do a throwback to a previous episode, so I guess.
But it wasn't even related. Let's try that again. What were you trying to say?
Shut up. I don't do second takes. That's the first thing you should know about me. The first thing you should know is I don't do second takes. And third of all, I love myself.
Are there any cons?
And I will never
Russian
come
guy?
In fourth place. Go on.
Oh, wait. I have a pro of a Russian guy. I was telling you this earlier. A little anecdote about me. I woke up and to inspire myself this morning, I was looking at swing solo dance competitions. So those are freaking amazing. It's a lot of people like doing really cool moves. And then sometimes, okay, this guy I was watching, who I'm pretty sure is Russian because his name was super Russian. It was like Kirill Rotichev or something.
Yeah, that sounds pretty Russian.
And he was a beautiful man, and he was in this little gray suit, and he was dancing his ass off.
He did this, watch. Did he do that?
Is your mic wired through your drawstring?
No, that's my headphones.
The black one?
My headphones, honey. I have an extension cord so I can go multiple feet away.
Oh. Okay.
Something about me, I guess.
Okay, that's
interesting how
like
you
him.
Can't tell a full story without being distracted by me.
Okay, another detail about this beautiful Russian man. He's an amazing dancer. One of his moves was literally to do a flip on one hand and then land in the splits.
Oh, I can do that shit easy.
Oh. Well, let's
the
see.
Camera's too high, so you won't see it, so I won't bother. But
oh.
Yeah, in person, I'll show you.
Next
time we hang out in person, it's been, what, almost 2 years?
You're not going to be showing me a... fucking flip. You can't even flip a burger on the stove.
Honey, I have. I did that not even 4 weeks ago. Whenever I was at our parents' house, I was flipping the shit out of some burgers.
That was pros and cons. Hey. Hey.
What you say? I don't know what to do today. What's the smell like? Do you want to lay down with me? We can sit in the tree.
We've talked. talked about all sorts of guys, from the guys to the shy guys, the Russian guys and the tech guys. Tech genius, you're fucking with the genius. I don't say anything else. I don't say what yourself. What the hell? He's calling someone on the phone. I tell him leave them all alone. They don't wanna talk, they wanna walk. Walk, walk away, walk away, away. I don't know what to say, say, say.
Hey, is this the Domino's on 21st and Midhoffer?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. This is a Pizza Pals call. Does, I used to work there. Does Antoinette work there?
No, she does not.
Oh. What about Louis?
No, he doesn't either. We have a lot of new people here.
Tasha?
We've got a new general manager.
Oh, Tasha had a boil on her face. Does Tasha work there?
No, she doesn't.
Oh, who's the new GM?
What about a delivery driver named David? He's been here for a while.
Oh, no, not David. What about Jason?
No, there's no Jason here.
Marco?
No.
End of an era. Hey, so what happened to Victor, the Russian guy? Victor had some health issues. I saw on Facebook that he lost his leg.
All right, well, I gotta go.
Hubble. I'm concerned about what you're telling them. This is your celebration. Was that all true, or was that some of that lies? Because you're not, first of all, you're not on Facebook, but why was I believing that you saw somebody's leg got cut off?
Sometimes people are forced to do bad things. They're put into a system where they have no choice but to tell, you know, an 18-year-old who's working 60 hours a week that, hey, I can only give you $8.25. That's all I can fly right now.
Sometimes we learn hard lessons the hardest ways. On that day, I will learn that not everything is fair, and even good people have to do bad things sometimes. Now he calls up the Dominoes, and he lies to them for fun.
I did one lie, maybe two. I can't remember what the other one would have been. They didn't even sell anchovies at the Indianapolis store, but the Iowa City one they did, and every time you put the anchovies in the oven, the whole room stunk. Stinky.
Stinky.
Kind of like this show when you join the Zoom call.
This one is called...
Drips. Is it called Drips?
It's called Improv. It's just called Improv, I guess. That's all it says in my notes. Oh. Hello?
Let me see if I have a sound for that. That sounds right. All right, we'll try it again. Places.
Hello?
Hey, hi. I was wondering if you had anything stinky and smelly that I could throw at someone to make them go away from me.
Sir. What type of sports were you made fun of for? Was it like a dodgeball situation?
Basketball, football, dodgeball, volleyball, probably tennis.
Would you say...
soccer.
What kind of words were they calling you?
Pussy. Fag. Bitch.
Sorry if you can hear the wrestling. I'm going through the catalog.
Oh, okay.
I'm going through the catalogs. They're all made of plastic.
I'm actually...
You there?
Hey, I'm here.
I'm losing you.
Are you okay? Are you sick? You sound sick.
I'm not sick.
There's kind of a stomach thing going around. My boss, Miss Girdle, she has diarrhea tummy issues. She said so in an email. I don't know who's calling. I'm not going to pick it up. I don't recognize the number. I'll just let it go to voicemail. Oh, it looks like I have a new voicemail. I'll listen to it. it's a stupid asshole.
Are you ready for your next segment?
Yeah, it's called I Gotta Go Soon. It's called I Gotta Go Soon, because I gotta go soon.
Are you making a joke about how this generation's always on their phone and never outside?
This generation is only on their phone inside. My generation, we went outside and we smelled the smells of outside.
Hey, we got to do a smell compilation because this episode was smell heavy on your end.
Probably.
Now let's listen to this dubstep.
You think I would look pretty on your arm once you cover up my bruises and battle scars,
but it'll be stinky poop. Suffocate, don't make me bleed. Stinky poop. Lose
your mind from endless breath. Goodbye, everybody. This has been 98.8 WLOL. Who's laughing out loud?
I am.
This has been an amazing episode with thousands of great segments and sounds and little words that we've been pouring out of our mouths for your enjoyment. For your enjoyment, this has been my gay brother Hubble.
Hey!
And I am Elijah. If you are a swing dancing Russian man, you can ring my line any day of the week. Other than that, we want you to be commenting down below. Comment down below your pros and cons of different types of guys, or these types of guys. What type of guy are we? Maybe let us know. And don't just say gay guys.
It's kind of reductive.
That's kind of obvious. Okay, we love you.
Bye, honeys. This song is so good.
I actually liked that song. Is that?
Wow.
No, I liked it.